There's been a lot of talk in the news lately about capital gain taxes. So capital gain is basically your profit on an asset. For real estate, to calculate that, you basically take what you net when you sell the property, and that would be the selling price minus whatever fees and taxes you pay. You would subtract your cost basis, and then that gives you the amount that could possibly be subject to capital gain. So two things I want to explain is, one, how you calculate cost basis. It would be what it cost you to acquire the property, but you can also add in improvements that you made on the property, such as new windows, if you added a deck, if you did, you know, landscaping. So save all of your receipts for when you spend money on your house. It could make a big difference on your taxation. The other part of that is that as a married couple, you have a $500,000 exclusion. As a single person, you have a $250,000 exclusion for the capital gains tax. So what that means is, if you sell your home and you're single, the first $250,000 profit, if you will, your capital gain, is not subject to taxation. Now, there are some caveats to that. You need to have lived in the home for two of the last 5 years as your primary residence. And that is something that the IRS are very strict about. So you want to make sure that you can document that. Another factor that's come into play in the news lately is that Washington State is looking at having a capital gain tax on the sale of assets. The proposed taxation does exclude real estate, so that's good news. The other thing that's been in the news lately is 1031 like-kind exchanges. So that allows investors who have a rental house to, you know, sell that house and take the amount that they realize from that reinvest it in another property and not have to pay capital gains tax at that time. It's a deferred tax program. It's not a get out of jail free card. So that program encourages investments. And there is some talk of eliminating 1031 like-kind exchanges. That has been proposed many, many times in the past by both Democratic and Republican administrations, but the research has shown over and over again that 1031 like-kind exchanges are good for the economy. So it generally is felt that probably it won't be eliminated, but there probably will be changes. So my message is, one, if you make any home improvements at all on your property, make sure you save all of those receipts. Number two, if you are selling a property that you have not had as your primary residence for the last 2 years, consider if it makes sense for you to move back into that property if you're going to have taxation that's significant. And number three, of course, is before you make your final decision, make sure that you do talk to your accountant. This is not meant to be accounting advice, but we certainly can let you know what your property is worth in today's market, because a lot of people are taking advantage of the high, high selling prices in order to be able to cash out on their primary residence or even their investment properties. If you're downsizing, this is the absolute best time to consider doing that. If you have questions on the value of your property, give me a call. If you have questions on your taxation, it's a very taxpayer specific event, so I would recommend you talk to an accountant. I'm Jean Groesbeck, the Groesbeck Group, Compass Real Estate. Would love to help you.